Tonight, Bob Ehrlich is accusing Governor Martin O'Malley of using a state agency to deceive Maryland residents for political purposes.
And Ehrlich says he has the documents to prove it. Tonight, State House Republican leaders are calling for an investigation into what they say amounts to a cover-up and censorship. 11 News reporter David Collins has tonight's Commitment 2010 report.
Job loss as a result of hostility and sometimes negligence and sometimes just inconsistency.
Bob Ehrlich considers the Department of Labor and Licensing the most broken agency in state government and accuses Martin O'Malley of using it to his own political advantage. Last month, the agency posted this memo proclaiming Maryland's economic recovery faltered in July. The document stayed on the state website for some 5 hours, then disappeared, and was replaced by a more upbeat summary. At the time, Secretary Alex Sanchez explained the report was completely internal and not meant for the public. Republicans call it a cover-up, not an accident.
Today I'm angry. I'm angry as a member of the General Assembly. I'm angry as a member of the Senate Finance Committee that oversees dollar. And I'm mad as a Maryland citizen that my government is hiding things from me to promote a public political campaign.
Exhibit A, O'Malley administration emails the Ehrlich campaign obtained through a Public Information Act request. One of them reads, some of the material on the update was diametrically opposed to the discussed and eventually approved messaging. Secretaries Johansson and Sanchez, as well as the governor's senior staff, were very upset to see this on our website. I instructed Michelle to take it down. On the same day, the governor issued a statement proclaiming for the fifth straight month, Maryland experienced job growth, marking the best performing January through July period in Maryland since 1999.
When one level of that government makes stuff up and you can no longer trust the veracity of their words, then the whole concept of self-governance kind of flies out the window.
In another email, the spokesman for labor asks, are we sure that removing that post remove all traces of it? Whatever we can do to make it disappear, we need to do it. That's coming straight from the top.
That allows Maryland to become that epicenter of cyber security.
Governor O'Malley participated in the grand opening of the Cyber Innovation Center in Columbia. He declined to take questions. His staff said he had to leave for a bill signing at the White House.
State House Republicans are discussing whether to launch a full-blown investigation, calling witnesses before a joint committee, not only to determine what happened in this case, but in the words of one Republican leader, to find out what other agencies the governor is using to deceive the citizens of Maryland. At the Department of Labor and Licensing downtown, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.